What is the value of the expression 90 minus 45 divided by 9 times 5? Which option do you think is the correct answer to this question? This expression has tricked almost 95% of people. Let's break it down and solve it together. To solve this question, most people first go for the subtraction between 90 and 45, and they rewrite it as 45 divided by 9 times 5. And the next step, they usually perform the division between 45 and 9, and simplifying this expression to 5 multiplied by 5, which finally gives them the answer 25. And immediately, they quickly say that the correct answer to this question is option A. However, this answer is absolutely wrong. Also, some other people when solving this question, first go for the multiplication between 9 and 5, because they think multiplication has a higher priority than division. So, they rewrite this expression as 90 minus 45 divided by 45. And the next step, they perform the division between 45 and 45, since they believe division has a higher priority than subtraction. And they simplify this expression to 90 minus 1, which finally gives them the answer 89. Then, they quickly say that option C is the correct answer to this question. But, I have to say, we're tricked and it's not the correct answer to this question. Alright, now let me show you how to solve this expression properly. To solve this question, we must follow a rule that is called PEMDAS. And this rule, P stands for parentheses, E stands for exponent, M stands for multiplication, D stands for division, A stands for addition, and S stands for subtraction. We should perform these operations exactly in order from top to bottom. Okay, according to the PEMDAS rule, we must start with the division and multiplication, because these two operations have a higher priority than subtraction. However, it's very important to keep in mind that multiplication and division have exactly the same level of priority. In this situation, the best approach is to start from the left and perform these two operations in order. So, first we perform the division between 45 and 9, and instead of this expression, we can write 90 minus 5, then times 5. In the next step, we should perform the multiplication between 5 and 5, because multiplication has a higher priority than subtraction. So, this expression simplifies to 90 minus 25. And finally, we get the answer 65. That's great. Option B is the correct answer to this question. Alright, now let's solve another tricky math question together. What is the value of the expression 64 divided by 8, again divided by 64 divided by 8? Which option do you think is the correct answer to this question? Let's carefully go through the step by step and solve it together. At the beginning of solving this question, many people jump straight to the first expression, 64 divided by 8, which I have highlighted in yellow, and replace it with 8. And the next step, they go for the other expression of 64 divided by 8, that I have highlighted in blue, and again replace it with 8. Finally, they conclude that 8 divided by 8 is equal to 1. Then, they conclude that option C is the correct answer to this question. However, that's definitely wrong. Alright, now let me walk you through step by step how to solve this expression properly. As you can see in the image, in this expression, we have three division signs. It's very important to note that when an expression contains only division signs, we must always move from left to right and carry them out in order. So, first we start with the expression 64 divided by 8, which I have highlighted in yellow. And instead of this expression, we can write 8 divided by 64, then divided by 8. Now, we can rewrite 8 divided by 64 in the form of a fraction. So, this expression becomes 8 over 64 divided by 8. Alright, whenever we see a division sign between two terms, the best strategy is to use the KCF rule. In this rule, K stands for keep the first fraction as it is. C stands for change the division sign to multiplication. And F stands for flip the second number. So, instead of the highlighted part, we rewrite it as 8 over 64 multiplied by 1 over 8, which ultimately gives us 8 over 512, and it simplifies to 1 over 64. Therefore, option A is the correct answer to this question.